The only way to learn is to be on the battlefield yourself.
The only way to learn
is on the battlefield yourself.
You cannot go to the battlefield without shield and sword. You must be prepared. So you must hold the shield and sword. If you go to the battlefield without shield and sword, the seven sons of Sceva, you have read in the book of Acts, the evil spirit attack you. But if you have sword and shield, you kill the evil spirit and God give you promotions. You get mansions, you get heavenly currency.
My name is Julia. I'm here in France. I have migraine. I have eye problems. I cannot
find the name of Jesus Christ. So viewers, what am I looking at? So madam, you know, your breast. Things have been disturbing your breast also.
I've been having pain sometimes. In fact, I've been having pain on my chest. It's like the pain goes to my breast. So
viewers, you know what the book of Jeremiah says? Jeremiah says, when the word of God come into me, it is like in my heart burning. So how am I able to tell Madam Julia all of a sudden this and that? How am I able to discern whether it is my own imaginations or the voice of the Holy Spirit? The difference is the level of faith. So viewers, I will say it again. The difference is level of faith. On your case, you do not know whether it is your imaginations or the voice of the Holy Spirit. Is it a vision or is it from my mind because I watch too much movies? How do I know? It is the fire of God burning in my heart that gives me the indication that this is the voice of the Holy Spirit. Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 9. And I read, but if I say, I will not mention his word or speak anymore in his name. His word is in my heart like a fire shut up in my bones. I am weary of holding it in. Indeed, I cannot. So how do I know? It is the indication. You know, God is so merciful to us. He knows that we are humans. The level of faith. God can give you indication that this is his voice and not your own imaginations. So this is why from time to time, you can see the Rod of Iron Church say, you have two children. Where's your daughter? You know, lightning strike yesterday. This is spirit of death. Yes, yesterday my family member died. You were molested when you were younger. And I'm looking at you sitting on a toilet bowl. When you are sitting at the toilet bowl, the evil spirit enter you. The indication to know that this is the voice of God. You know, Madam Julia, God just gave this as a spice, as an ingredient to build up your faith that yes, the healing of the Lord is upon your body. The people of the world today, the people coming to men of God for prayer, they want confirmation that they will receive the healing. So here comes the confirmation. Pastor David, pray for you. I agree with Pastor David. But now Madam Julia is, amen. I take your word in, man of God. Pastor David, I take your word in. I will be healed. Here comes the confirmation. And the issue on your chest, your breast, God will heal it, do a total cleansing for you. You know, in the Synagogue Church of All Nations, there is a huge sentence that writes over the church. It says, if millions of today are to believe, they must see that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That Jesus Christ still works today. How can they see? We must give confirmation. This is your issue. I will tell you will be healed. Not only that, I also go behind your problem and tell you another prophecy to confirm the first issue. I will say it again. This is your issue. I will go behind around you and I'll squeeze out a prophecy from God to confirm this issue that you will indeed be delivered. Jesus and the Samaritan woman. Woman, you will indeed receive the living water, also known as the Holy Spirit. Because the Samaritan woman said, Lord, always give me this water to drink so that I do not need to come to this well to draw water again. Jesus Christ said to her, I see your faith. You can receive the Holy Spirit. You can receive the living water in me. But let me tell you another prophecy so that you can believe it. You can believe what I'm saying. Call your husband and come back. Lord, I do not have a husband. At this time, many of the men of God will now say in his heart, wow, this is big time. I just spoke a wrong prophecy. Huh? Call your husband and come back. Sir, I do not have a husband. At this time, men of God will now say, after this service, let me go and repent because I spoke a wrong prophecy. But Jesus Christ is not shaken. Jesus Christ said, no, you have 5 husbands and the one that you're living with now is not your husband. He followed through the prophecy. Remember what I said 1 hour ago? I said, the fact that you're able to give a correct prophecy does not mean you will finish the prophecy well. You must be carried along by the Holy Spirit. Call your husband and come back. Sir, I don't have a husband. No, I'm looking at 5 men. And the man that you're living with now is not your husband. Okay, so do we get the message now? Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Many gifts we are taking away home. We are taking home now. Straight from the furnace of the Holy Spirit. Many, many gifts is building out your faith. Amen. Jesus Christ said, you are already cleansed by my word that I spoke to you.